Looking across the landscape, we are stuck in a stubborn weather pattern right now.
We certainly are, and it's gray days, too. I kind of miss the sunshine. Let's check in now with First Alert Chief Meteorologist Tony Manolfi.
You know, we're going to see a little more sunshine once we get past tomorrow, just in time for your weekend plans. How about that? If you're going to make it to the attractions this weekend, just know that there will be some afternoon storms, but the overall coverage will be getting back to a more normal pattern here across Central Florida. A bit of a breeze out there as well with some of those storms today through Brevard County. Saw peak wind gusts over towards central Brevard County of 46 miles an hour. A little bit of a breather. We're heating back up. We'll have to wait and see if a new line of showers and storms can fire on up as we're seeing temperatures climb back up into the middle and the upper 80s along the west side of the peninsula. We've seen a few showers just now beginning to percolate here through Marion County, a bigger cluster with some lightning strikes up towards Hot Springs. So we'll watch the trends on this going forward. Wednesday rainfall so far. Coquina Elementary, 1.30 inches of rain. Used to this middle school, about an inch of rain. And over towards Pearson, about 3/4 inch of rain. Temps outside now rebounding nicely into the middle in the upper 80s, the exception being Brevard County, where that round of rain has just moved offshore. You're still running in the mid-70s out there. Winds are out of the west-southwest at about 10 to 15 miles an hour. As we take a look at the hour-by-hour forecast here, we'll watch for the potential for storm development up north and west, where we're getting that sunshine right now. And once it gets going, we may have a couple of lingering showers like we've seen the previous couple of nights. Overnight lows tonight, a little bit warmer, 73 to about 77 near shore in Brevard County. Overnight flow on it to Thursday out of the west-southwest. That means the coverage of storms will fire up north and west, and then again work back towards the eastern side of the peninsula. High temperatures tomorrow before the showers and storms get going. Ocala 89, Eustis and Claremont coming in around 90, back towards Kissimmee, Winter Park, and Oviedo as well, right around the 90-degree mark. A little bit warmer south and east with a little more sunshine. Palm Bay, Cocoa, over towards Keenesville. Now, the tropics, we got a weak low here, not too worried about that. And Dorian getting her act better organized here over the last 24 hours. Still roughly about just shy of 2,000 miles from the Leeward Islands, but you can see the symmetry of this storm getting better organized out there right now. In fact, as we show you the IR, you can see the banding ongoing now as it continues to move off towards the west northwest. Now, there is some drier air, so that will slow any potential growth down. That combined with cooler waters, so a gradual buildup in that wind speed once we get you out past 24 hours on approach now to the Leeward Islands. We've seen a lot of African dust over the last 7 to 10 days, but that has gone away now with Dorian on board, not as dusty, so the Saharan air layer is not going to be that much of an issue. Let's take a look now at the track here as we get you through Friday on into Saturday, and then here we go into Sunday. We'll have to watch that approach to San Juan. Plenty of time to watch it. Keep checking back in. We'll keep you posted. Here's your updated 7-day forecast now. Rain chances at 50% on Thursday. As we head into the weekend, they are going down and temperatures are going up.
Tony, thanks.